Gonna be doing something a little bit different today. I've got Elite Dangerous all ready to rock. I've got my Vive all hooked up, and we're gonna try a VR stream. Should be interesting. There's just cables absolutely everywhere, so this is gonna be a little bit difficult. But hey, we'll give it a go. We'll give it a good go. So yeah, just getting this all up and running. I've got all the VR stuff going, and I've done a bit of a check with the audio and all that sort of stuff. So we're going to start Elite up, and this is going to be in VR mode. So yeah, this should be cool. And basically what I'm planning on doing at the moment is just doing the journey back to Jameson's. Just in VR to make it a little bit more interesting, since it's just going to be a bunch of jumps, but also just kind of get used to it a little bit as well. So yeah, it's going to be like it's not going to be completely full screen because of the VR thing, but you'll see it in a minute once it loads up properly. Elite in VR, I gave it a little bit of a test run beforehand. It really is something to behold. It's really, really great. I haven't got the best VR headset at all, not by any stretch of the imagination, not these days. I got a HTC Vive. It is the sort of consumer one, not the dev kit one or anything like that. But obviously these days, with a lot of the improvements that have been made with the recent stuff, and I'm just going to tweet this out. A lot of the improvements that they've made with the recent headsets, it's kind of incredible. But this still does the job. It's just not as clear as maybe you would want it to be, really. But I haven't really done anything better. I haven't tried anything better myself than this. HTC Vive Pro is not much different, to be honest with you. I never really noticed much difference in the clarity. And HoloLens is a completely different type of thing. What's it called? Oculus. The other thing, the Oculus. There's that. They're good. The newer stuff is looking good. I wouldn't mind trying out an Index. I wouldn't mind trying out the new Oculus. Is seeing what they're like. But anyway, let's get into this. I'm essentially going to be blind. So hey, have fun. And I'll just see what this is like. Like the VR version of Elite, it's not much difference. They sort of changed the viewpoint so that when you start, you're like, you know, a human being on the ground looking up at your ship, which is just amazing. I love that. I think that's so cool. So I'm going to do a little bit of tour of the ship as well, sort of in the sort of little bit that we can sort of move around and stuff. Obviously, what you kind of don't get, I suppose, just as a viewer, is you don't get the depth perception or the 3D effect, which really is, honestly, it's than strapping a couple of screens to your face and feeling sort of immersed in it. That's the thing that makes it tick for me. It's just the 3D sort of being completely separated from the outside world, and the 3D aspect of it is it, really. Like everything else is a plus. You know, the actual wands, controllers and moving around does obviously help, but in a cockpit type game like this, all you need is the 3D and the immersion, really, the head tracking. But yeah, let's get this on and we'll get into it. I even had to change my glasses into like the smaller frames so I could get this on. You know, honestly, like, the sooner we can get VR to the point where let's go. Sooner we can get VR to the point where ooh, I have to reset this. This is all a little bit off. Yeah, this is a little bit. I'm going to have to restart the game to get it to center. I'm not sure how else you can get it to center. Right, let me hold this here whilst I restart this. Oh, that is just the best. Just look at my headless corpse. whilst there we go. So because this is VR, this could be a shorter sort of stream, might only be an hour or so, but I just wanted to try it out, really. But it looks like it's running okay, you know. Other than that, let's see if we can get this recent to do. Come on, anytime you're ready. Right then, let's try this again. So this is all good, all 2D and everything at the moment. There we go, I think that's a bit better. Gonna shift the cable behind us. Oh wow, there we go. Yeah, so this is proper decent now. See, they've got the crate there and all of its glory. So yeah, other than just being closer, oh there we go, that's a little bit better. Although I kind of got no neck at the moment, but that's fine. Oh well, figure this out. So let's have a look around the ship, shall we? I'm gonna watch out for this cable stuff. So there we go, and I gotta watch out that I don't walk into my desk or anything like that. So there we go. I've got the chair there. Got to watch out for the boundaries there. It's the whole cockpit thing. Let me just get out of there a little bit. There's the chair. Okay. And it's just great that you can see sort of back here. You can't normally see around the back here, you know. It's just gorgeous there. So, soon trip TM. Hopefully we'll be able to walk around this in the normal game, you know. Walk beyond like this bit here. It's pretty damn cool. So yeah, I even like the lighting. Like you got the nav panel there, and the lighting on the metal there as that comes up. Yeah, that's just the coolest thing. And so we've got these sort of windows here. Just losing tracking. There we go. We got those windows there. And bits of the ship up there, bits of the ship up there. And all this cockpit, this huge cockpit. It's just, it's something else. Right, I've got to try and sit down. I think I've got this. And those little, I'm going to have to watch out for the chair. Those little ornaments that go on the dashboard. They seem a little bit too big. Because I bet you I suppose I can't because the desk is in the way, but if I could walk up to there, they look a little bit too big. Yeah. Anyway, let's let's go where we gotta go. Hopefully I don't have to do anything too much with this. Oh my god. That's pretty cool. It's a good thing we've got this there we go. It's a good thing we've got the like a frame of reference here, otherwise this would be a bit much maybe. So you got the throttle there. I love the fact you can see that. You got reverse thrust there. And I love how the hands just like copy what you do on the sticks. It's so cool. Oh, hang on a sec. I gotta switch to like the combat mode. Where's the space button? Nope, that's not it. There we go. Get to the pulse lasers. So there we go. So they must be like on the front of that there, or on the top. I'm not actually sure where they are. I think it might be on the top. But anyway. You know, great lighting, all that sort of stuff. It's just cool. It's just cool. Okay, now I gotta swap back to that thing. Ah, it's this mode. There we go. All right then. Oh boy. Okay. Yeah, I gotta sit back in the chair. I have to admit, I feel a little bit maybe like weird with my body being a little bit too far out. So it's a bit hard to see there, but like that's like a 3D thing which like pops out and isn't on the Windows screen or on the cockpit screen. It's different seeing it in 3D when you're used to seeing it in 2D all the time. Oof. Yeah, that's a little bit that's a little bit scary, not gonna lie. No fuel scooping, and it's so natural to sort of move your head and do that, but it's also kind of weird that you're physically moving your head rather than just pressing the button, which I can still do. It's just it just turns on the panel, whereas I can just look at it. It's just it's really cool, and I can go through the logs here, all that sort of stuff. Yeah. It's one of those sad things, that it's just really, really difficult to show off VR and the feeling of it, I suppose, via, like, just video. It really is one of those things where I suppose you've got to try it yourself, but you also need to be in the right environment to try it, not like in a busy sort of trade show floor or all that sort of thing. It's just, it's not the same, you know. At least not for me. That sun's really bright. Unsurprisingly. But you get the feeling of like, you know, it is like, yeah, a little bit of motion sickness when you've got like a star as a point of reference. Like when it's just a ship on your own, you can sort of, you know, and they fly around all like this, and it's, hey, it's no big deal, it's all good fun. And you see the star field moving around, and it's also, yeah, like basically the background, you know. Which I imagine is how it feels in real life as well. But as soon as you got like a, I need to get some more fuel here. As soon as you got a field of reference, like a point of reference, it suddenly starts feeling a little bit like I feel like I should be getting motion, but I'm not getting any motion. Like the feeling of I should be getting like some gravitational pull maybe or something, but I don't know. Like G-forces, like you do when you're driving. But sort of not getting that, it feels kind of weird. Like even when you're on a plane, you sort of feel the landing and when they're playing banks and all that sort of thing, and just you don't get any of that here, which I suppose is realistic because you're in space, and I suppose you wouldn't get any of that. I don't know, I suppose it depends how you do artificial gravity. I got an itchy eye. I swear to God, like this is the most comfortable VR headset I've actually ever had, or ever tried. I did think about maybe going back to that black hole that we saw yesterday, but the problem is that it's just, it's so far. And it took long enough to get there, and I just like, I don't want to go through that again. I would like to see it in VR, but not right now. Oh, I forgot to mention, like, the, I think the external camera works. Oh, yeah, the external camera works in VR, which is odd, to say the least. There you go, I'll do it again in a minute when we go back. Yeah, I do like just looking around hyperspace. We should see if we can get the Thargoids to pull us out of hyperspace when we're in VR as well. That'd be cool. There we go. Alright, I gotta slow down a bit because I won't understand what's going on. So, yeah. That's cool. That's kind of cool. I suppose that really I should be saying that's hot. Oh. We're getting a bit close to that yellow line. I gotta go back in that cockpit. Oh. Yeah, so that's interesting. We've got 6 jumps, so not that many to go. Shouldn't take too long. I do like this jacket. I'm really happy that I got this jacket. Just look at that. What a cool ass jacket. The whole outfit is lovely. I do fear that I basically just look like I'm just like mouth open, like looking around at this stuff. Oh, clipping into the headrest there. Alright, how are we doing? Was that a brown dwarf? Oh, I keep on hitting the what's this? The pop filter. Oh, I tried to think what state this is in right now. Okay. So I think really the only thing stopping me from playing this full time in like VR is the fact that I can't see the keyboard, and I still need the mouse and keyboard and so many other keys to really play this without fumbling around. It's really great though. I do like it. It's cool for the sightseeing aspect, I've got to give it that. I do really just like being able to see around the cockpits and around the ships. It's pretty cool. Wow, I'm glad we... Oof, oh, wow, look at that. It's doing that thing. This isn't a... God, that's really bright. Can we have an injection kit? Oof. Where are we going to go? We're not going to be able to... Here are we? There we go. Alright, no, I do need to I do need to charge up, but I need to find that ejection cone. Where's that star gone? There it is. Where are the ejection cones? Are they over here? Oh, I see. I think... Gotcha, they're small and it's really bright. I don't want to crash into this thing, for Christ's sake. Oh, there we go. I guess that's it. It's just it's not messing me around, that's all. Weird. Okay. Maybe I need to go back? It's disconcerting when you can't see the... Can't see the thing. Can't see the cone. Let's go this way. Oof. Got the- I need you to get it out the way. Ah, I saw it there for a second. There it is. I see it. I see it. I see it. I actually need to block out the rest of the sun. Just so you can see it. This is going to be tough because this is really close. Alright, I need to like charge it up and then really get out of it. Okay, hopefully we can get out of here now. Oh, that's the sun. That's the sun. I need to get away from that. Oh god, that's actually kind of terrifying. I got another bright one coming up, I think. Oh yeah. System scan complete. I have to admit, like, having VR to be able to look around like this is much easier. There we go. That's all we needed. That's all we needed. Space travel is terrifying. Breather for a sec, because, you know, holy crap, it's been 25 minutes already, like, holy shit. Okay, I need to get away from that. I need to put this back on in a minute. I just want to get away from the Death Star. Okay. Ah, there we go. Oh, we're almost there as well. Shinrata Desura. 11 light years. Sweet. Do we even need to do this? Or can we just run away? Oh, we can just run away. Excellent. I don't need to jump. Charge and jump. Alright. Take me to Shinrata Desura. Take me home. Star doesn't scare me so much. It's just a nice, normal, friendly star. Alright, we better I better start thinking about getting away from the heat. I can't stand the heat. Get slightly further away from the star. There we go. Just want to get that last bit of fuel. There we go. Okay, I need to find Jameson's. There we go, 300 out. Nothing too shabby. And we made it. Lovely. I gotta find my mouse. Where is my mouse?
Contact
There it is. Oh, okay, that's moving with my head as well. Cool. I suppose that's good. Okay. Oh. Okay. Let's get some ship integrity back. Oh yeah, fixed the paintwork. I paid for that paintwork. Oh yeah. We have some stuff to sell. Whoa. Access to docking facilities requires flight control authorization. That's cool. Right. right. What do we have here? Contacts. Search and rescue, authority, combat band, technology broker. Ah, so what have we got here? Right, Guardian. Okay, so this is all Guardian stuff. Combat bond, search and rescue, authority. Shouldn't have any vines, I don't think. Actually, I'm going to use my mouse for this because I think it'll be easier. Yeah, I'm still just kind of. I think I need to turn off the mouse movement with the head movement because that's. That's a little weird. So I'm pretty sure. Yeah, no, that's fine. Oh, I wasn't sure, but I was thinking you probably can't even get the what they're called, the corrosion resistant cargo racks from here, but I did just want to check. That's okay. I want to go land on the planet anyway, so let's go find a planet which we can land on. Just to drive the SRV in VR as well. Try and take off myself. Just because, oh god, yeah, you really get the feeling of that, don't you? Is that Beluga? Yeah, it's a Beluga. pretty cool. So I want to try and get like on the I forget what it's called now, the line where the light meets the dark. It's got a cool name and I can't remember what it's called. Terminus, I think it's something like it's the Terminator. It's the Terminator, I'm pretty sure that's it, right? On that line, get some nice views. And this is a particularly sort of boring planet. There's nothing much to it, you know. It's just a rock, but still think we can get some nice views otherwise. Don't know what the orbit period is like, but maybe we can get a sunrise or a sunset or something. That'd be cool. Sort of area there. I sort of realized what's going on with the mic here. I think there we go. So just sort of feeding my way around the mic. Yeah, there we go. Now we're looking in the right area. Let's see if... That is kind of useful. It will be two kilometers. What I do not want to do is plow into this planet. Gravity is a little bit more than I thought it was. It's like about Earth gravity, actually. So it's a good thing I did sort of slow down. Fun. Like, it's not so bad when you're in a ship because it's sort of slower and it moves around a bit slower and all that sort of stuff, but when you're in a little car, I just feel like this is gonna get crazy. At least we've got higher gravity though, so maybe that'll help. I feel like the frame rate's suffering a little bit here as well, just a little bit. It just sort of feels ever so slightly 100%. Maybe I need to reduce the graphics or something, but anyway, we'll see how long I last. Let's just turn off those lights. Oh yeah, no, that's fine. We've got the ship lights, haven't we? Oh, look at that. All right. Dismiss ship. Let's have a look at the ship. Oh yeah, look at that. So I'll be like, I've got a gun up there, and we've got our lights there. Oh yeah, that's done. Cool. Oh, this is rad. Oh yeah, look at that. Now we're just a little pod. Let's take a little bit of a look around here, as soon as we can. Okay, that's cool. Can I go out this way? I can. Awesome. Oh, this is going to be... let's just stop for a second, because holy crap. There we go. Alright. Oh, wow, this is really big. Like, bigger than I thought. Oh, that's the jet engine. That's the... Yeah, let's find the controls for that. I gotta find my way back to where it is. That's awesome. Oh god, this is gonna get, this is gonna be slightly sickening. Oh god. Yeah, okay, cool. Right. So now we get a better look at it. So there's a chassis cargo unit, impact resistant shell, what's that, Roman numeral 5, 6, 7, 7. So bad with Roman numerals. That's really cool. There's my headless body once again. So this is the, is this the chair? Where's the rest of the chair? There's the rest of the chair. Okay. The good thing is that pretty much where your body is where the rest of it is. So there we go. I don't like standing up and going this fast. Oh man, that's the worst. I wish I left more space in front of us so I could go in front of us a bit more. Actually, I can go this way quite a lot. So I've got space, yeah, out of the pool. I wish you get more in the daylight. Then after that, have a proper look. Right. I just see myself falling over and not being able to get up. let's go towards the light. Go towards the light. Oof. I hit a thing. I hit a rock. This is always the way. There we go. At least we've got Earth gravity, more or less, in this, which is better than nothing. Except it means we're not so sort of. I'm gonna say so we're not bumping around so much, but so we're not sort of floating around so much, I guess. Sort of limit what we can do, maybe. It's not exactly. Ooh. Oh man. Should probably got the shit. Just fly there. Actually, that's not a bad idea. Let's get the ship and fly there. Ship. Jesus, just scared the crap out of me. Where are you going? Okay, so we're gonna fly a bit closer to the daylight, and then we're gonna get out in this, and then we can and get a proper look at this car and the ship actually in daylight. So why'd you go so far away? Rocks. Ow, rocks. Okay, there we go. That's a big rock. Nice ramp though, that would get us like maybe on top. Actually, just being able to do that is really nice. I'm going to assume that's like magnetic or something, so it doesn't ruin my immersion. Okay, let's go up to the sun. Oh, you know what? Now I'm going to have the lights on though, because... I want to be able to see... Yeah, nice bit of music as well, which is cool. The soundtrack of Elite is really great. That's kind of nice when it's a little bit filtered. Let's get a little bit of distance, maybe. Maybe that'll help. There we go, I'm going a little bit faster now. I'm getting to the sunlight. Still kind of want to keep a little bit of angle on it so it's, you know, so it kind of looks nice still. I'd be liking just in straight down, boring, broad sunlight. So I think maybe that'll be good over there. Yeah, this is better. This is also like a very small planet. Now that I'm sort of looking at it, because you can see the curvature from here, and that's not right, man.
Oof.
I forgot about the gravity. The very sort of Earth-like gravity. Come on, ship. Land. We're looking for a bit of yellow. Oh. There, that'll do it. That'll do it. Yep. Nope. Fold a bit. There you go. See, much better. There we go. Right, I think that's pretty good. Second. Okay, that's looking good. What I am just going to do is take a quick 2-minute break. And coming up on an hour, and I guess I'm going to go for another half an hour or so. Or maybe an hour, but I'm just going to take a very quick break and I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back, guys. Right, so we're going to have a little bit of a walk around the ship and the SRV and take a good look at it. In the sunlight, no less. I think that's actually setting. I think the sun's actually setting. Which is kind of neat. Okay.
Oh, delicious. The car's moving around a little bit. Just enough to sort of feel a bit funky. Okay. I guess we're still too close to the ship. Oh, yeah, the texture work, man. It's it's a little bit rough on this. But, that's what it's it. The trucks that the SRB has left are kind of hovering with the SRB over the over the rest of it. It's kind of funny.
That's fair.
Dirty turns on here. Oh, I just thought the mic's over there. You probably can't hear me, can you? Don't think I can go any further. I shouldn't be able to do that. Oh, okay. Oh, it's really freaking me. Yeah. Okay, where's the seat? Where's the seat? Where do I leave the seat? Oh, there it is. Okay. All right, I'm going to try and go the other side. Because, you know, that'd be interesting. I think it's loose. Yeah, no. Oh. Okay, yeah, it's loose. It's loose now. Oh, we've got some switches and stuff up here. All right. Oh, that's the mic. I just walked into the mic. Okay. There's another thing I want to try out. Why is that? Why is that not working? Oh, there we go. So yeah, it's pretty cool. It's pretty cool. Oh, it is a sunset as well. Oh. Okay. I don't know if we're going to be able to do this with Earth gravity, but I'm going to try and jump on top of my ship. I'm going to try and do it the other side. I always forget, that's not how you do that. Nice. There we go. Oh, that's the cockpit there. Isn't it? Yeah. Wonderful. Oh. Okay. Let's try that from here.
Headless body. Oh, nice, nice neck bracer.
Into areas of our own can't really fit. So.
That's good nuts.
Yeah, what about the bearings a little bit more now.
Okay, we're back and ready to go. So I always kind of think that we should be able to get like more, like further away and all that, but you kind of forget how much, I suppose how much real world space you need for some of these virtual spaces. Imagining that these are, you know, sort of realistic in the first place. Okay, we can just go straight through that. I'm going to fly around the other side of the planet, and instead of getting a sunset, we'll get a sunrise. I should probably turn my support back on. Oh, come on. There we go. Got a bit of the ice on there already. That's pretty cool.
Oh yeah, no, that was great.
Yeah, where is the keyboard? I'm gonna have to take off my headset to do this, I think. Oh yeah, it's getting frosty in here. And those are sun rays though, they do look absolutely spectacular. Absolutely beautiful actually, this is just great. That's the thing. There's the keyboard.
Yeah.
Let's try that.
Yeah, that's cool.
It's kind of speechless.
God.
Okay. Thought that sun would probably move quicker, but obviously not. All right, okay, there's that. And let's see if I can find G without really trying. Oh, is it going to be there? Nope. Oh, I'm definitely. Oh no, that's the top row. So home row. Hey. Got it. I do want to turn all the rest of this stuff on because I think that would be a good idea. I would like some sensors. Sensors would be good. I like sensors. Sensors help me see. And put a bit more power into the shield where they recharge, I think. I want to go down a bit, but not too far though. And put some lights on as well. Thinking we must have been a bit of a crest here before or something. Over here we've got some sunlight. Yeah, just in a bit of a dark spot down there, it looks like. That's all. Okay. Let's do a little bit of a see how we do with some low. Low altitude flying. It's not exactly the ship for it. I think it would be fun. Try and keep it below 100, I think. There we go. Just below 100, and what is that? Ah, we're getting a little weak. Okay, let's go see some of these, why not? Other side. Alright. I'm just sort of really getting a feel for this in VR, really. It's quite cool. It's very freeing to be able to just look around, like, in 3D space. That's really nice. You know. There's a lot of VR assists which I've not really got turned on at the moment, but like being able to turn off these panels when you look at them. So that you actually have to press the button for them to come up. I think that's pretty good. And I've got some like anti-nausea stuff, so the camera doesn't bump around too much when you've when you're on the SRV and all that. You know, like black out, so you don't just feel sick. But I've not got any of that stuff on at the moment. Just kind of want to see it as is, I guess. The weird thing is that a little bit of the scale does seem a little bit off at times. Like this cockpit does seem huge and all that, which is very nice for like views and all that. For an exploration ship, no problem. But those little the toys that they put on the on the dashboard there, they seem too big considering how far away that's supposed to be, so like they must be like pretty large, which I suppose is fine. Maybe I just thought they'd be smaller or something, but seems maybe, I don't know, they seem bigger than I was expecting. But everything else seems cool. Yeah, I like the holograms. They all seem about right. They seem further away than they maybe should be, I don't know, but yeah, just stuff like that really. But otherwise, everything else seems fine. Obviously, it's hard to judge some of the scale because I don't really know how big it's supposed to be anyway. You get the feeling that the SRV is supposed to be like one of the like the rovers that we've made for like the Mars missions and the moon missions, that sort of thing. And obviously, the ship is huge. But I think it's supposed to be huge though as well. It feels right for what it's supposed to be. Considering like we've never gone in like the rest of these ships or anything, but considering how they're sort of scaled out of VR as well, they seem about right, you know. Knocking the mic, which unsurprisingly is probably gonna mess up the audio a little bit. Need to slow down that descent a little bit. There we go. When things are a little bit further away than maybe you would expect, that's when you start to see maybe the resolution of the this version of the Vive in a way sort of come into play. You do get that sort of screen door effect, especially looking into space and all that as well. But you know, it is what it is. So it's still freaking amazing. Alright, now we gotta deploy RSRV. We'll go have a look at this base thing. I do like just being able to move around the ship as if it's like a real thing. That's so cool. Alright, where was that base? Was it this way? Do a scene behind us. Oh. Yes, okay, that's fine. No. Mining. I was expecting maybe a data thing to scan or something, but I guess not. Okie dokie then. All right, guys. I feel like I have had a decent amount of luck, a decent look at this in VR, and this is really quite something. However, I am feeling a little bit like I need to come back into the real world, so I think I will wrap up the stream here and get myself some soup. Oh, and yeah, I'll probably play a little bit more of this tomorrow. Just maybe normally. We'll see if we can find anything new. And I was thinking maybe next week I might swap over to a new game. Because then we've been doing Elite for a week. And I might, come back to it in a bit. Just so we don't get like burnt out on it. Or so I don't get burnt out on it. Which has definitely happened before. It's one of those games, you know, you play it all the time, I think you can get a bit burnt out with it. I like taking a break and then coming back and sort of loving it again and getting reacquainted with it. And maybe we'll start doing some engineering stuff or something. But I also wouldn't mind just starting like a different game as well. We'll see how we go from there. No thoughts on that yet, but we'll see. So, thanks very much, guys, for watching. I think I'm just gonna get out of there. I will see you next time, which should be tomorrow. All right, thanks very much, guys. A bit of a weird one, I know, today, but yeah. Thanks very much for watching. See you next time.